No, I don't waste no time.
What's going on, guys, and welcome back to a new video. For those of you that are new to the channel, my name is Joshua Daniel George, a digital marketing online coach. I have my own social media marketing agency called Brandpreneur here in the Netherlands, and I also have my own coaching business or education business where I teach you guys on how to do the same. So how to get your first client, how to build up your agency, scale it, automate it, so that you too can live life on your own terms. And the last video I published was a Q&A where I basically just answered some questions that you guys had and sent me in either the free Facebook group or on Instagram. By the way, guys, for those of you that are not yet in the free Facebook group, it's called the Lifestyle Design Community, where I basically just answer all of your questions, and there's also a free beginner course in there as well. So if you're not part of that community just yet, make sure you access it. It'll be linked in the description box down below, or on the header of my YouTube channel, you can also access it there as well. But anyway, like I said, Q&A, I answered questions that you guys sent over, but there were, you know, there were a few questions that I just didn't get to, or I didn't see in time, and I only saw, you know, after I actually shot the Q&A. And one of them was, how do I earn my clients money? And I thought, okay, that is quite an interesting question, actually. You know, why not just do a complete separate video on that? So basically what I do, because again, you know, for some people that have no idea what social media marketing is, it's still quite confusing. So what I do is I have my own agency where I help businesses grow by using paid traffic, and then in this case, Facebook advertising. So what I do is I set up Facebook ads for businesses online and basically help them attract more business. So if it's a web shop, I'll help them get more sales. If it's, for example, a dentist, I'll help them get more appointments, and so on and so forth. Now, at the time of recording this, we have, you know, the majority of our clients now are web shops. Why? Because obviously with COVID-19, a lot of our lead generation clients have paused, and we've been basically just going ham on the outreach for e-com clients, because like I said, you know, the web shops are least affected by the pandemic, so it's just easier to land clients like that. And obviously we had to compensate for a few of our lead generation clients pausing. Going forward, we'll probably just tailor completely, you know, everything completely to e-commerce. Why? Because I think there's a higher basically lifetime value of the niche. I think that web shops are the future, and I think that, you know, we might as well just get in now and tailor everything towards web shops before it's too late and we need to pivot again. So like I said, that is what we do. So we set up Facebook ads to help web shops get more sales, sell more products. So let's say, for example, you know, very, very simple example, the product, the price of the product is £1,000. Okay, so there's a web shop and the client is selling televisions for £1,000 each. Okay, and we set up Facebook ads for the clients, and you know, we use their ad budget. Again, quick side note, we do not pay for the ads. You know, the clients pay us a retainer, and we use their budget to pay for the ads. So that is how it works. The retainer is ours to keep, and then the ad budget that we get off the client is what we invest into ads. So it's a double investment on their part. However, it's basically, it's like when you build a house, you know, you pay the brickie for the work, but you don't make the brickie pay for all the bricks and stuff like that and the scaffolding. So anyway, like I said, we set up these Facebook ads, we use their budget to set them up, we get the retainer, we get paid up front, that's just how it works. And then let's say, because the price of product is £1,000, let's say we sell 10 televisions in the first month. So we've charged £1,000 for the retainer. We've set advertisements up for an additional £1,000, so the ad budget was £1,000, and we sell 10 tellies. So that way we've made the client £10,000 in revenue. He pays us the £1,000, which he already has done, so he's out of pocket first, but he earns it back. And that way, you know, he basically profited £8,000 in that month, you know, excluding the when you take away the ad budget as well. So that way we help the clients make more money, and that is how we're basically able to charge retainers of £1,000+, because the more money we make, or they make, the more money we can ask, and the more money we make, and that is how we try and create that win-win situation. Now let's say, for example, the client hasn't got £1,000 telly, but he's got a £10 pen. Okay, so he's selling pens for £10 each, and we only sell, let's say, 100 pens. So we make him £1,000 in revenue for that month. But Our retainer is also 1,000 and the ad budget was 1,000 as well. So he's made a £1,000 loss. Now that is obviously not sustainable. So the client will obviously leave us, or you know, you'll say, listen, you know, we need to see an increase in sales in the next month. Otherwise there's no point in me continuing the service. And in a situation like that, it's not a win-win situation, definitely not for the long term. Obviously, when starting out, you know, there can be months like that, but you know, the aim is to create a win-win situation. And the latter, what I just mentioned there, is not a win-win situation. So we either need to reduce our retainer or get them better results. And that is what we always aim for. We always aim to get the client more money than they've invested into us and invested into ads. So they invest twice, they invest into advertisements, they invest into our expertise, and the goal for us is to make him more money again. So like I said, £1,000 for us, or 1,500 for us, 1,000 or 1,500 in ads, and then we try and make them, the client, at least a 2x return on investment. And that is how we make the client's money, and that is how we run the business. And like I said, it's very easy when you think about it. You know, they invest in us, we've got a retainer, and the whole point of all of this is to make them more money, regardless of what it is. If it's a web shop, if it's lead generation, if they are selling info products, let's say that they are selling £100 workshop, online workshop, okay? And like I said, they invest 1,000 to us, 1,000 to ads, means we need to at least get them, you know, a 2,000 return. Otherwise, you know, below that, they are at a loss. If they get 2,000 back, which is 20 core sales, then they break even. Any more than 20, then obviously they're out of profit, and that is what we aim for. And the great thing about Facebook ads is it's all trackable. You can measure every single metric, which means that we, as soon as it is profitable and we do get them sales, we just know, okay, we need to just allocate more budget to it, because if it works, let's say we put £1 in, we get £2 out, then it's the same for if you put £200 in, or if you put £100 in, you get £200 out. And that is basically how it works. Obviously, you know, as soon as you scale, there will always be like a slight decrease in return on investment. That is just the way it works. But like, you know, basically the structure and the theory is that £1 in equals £2 out will be the same if you basically tenfold that. So that is all I've got for today. Short and sweet video, but I just wanted to answer that question, because obviously, you know, this is something that people do ask me on a regular basis. So this video can obviously clear that up. Like the video if you got something out of it. Comment down below if you've got any more questions for me, or if I missed your question in the last Q&A, just comment it down below. I'll add a reply or film a video on it. Make sure you check out the Lifestyle Design Community and request access to that as well, because like I said, there's a free mini course in there as well. If you are serious about social media marketing and you actually want my help and you want me to take you on as a client, where I basically help you build up your agency, I also have my own coaching business. Again, everything will be linked in the description box down below. If you're interested, we can hop on a quick call, see if we're the right fit for each other, because obviously it is quite intense for me as well. You know, it's quite a time demanding thing to do, to take you guys on as a client, but more than happy to do so. It's obviously part of the business. So like I said, it's all linked in the description box down below. Subscribe to the channel for more, and I'll see you guys in the next video.